All right, there it is.
Okay, everybody.
This is Bruce Rodriguez here.
Making a little different kind of video. Finally not messing with swarms today. Well, not yet. It's early in the morning. It's like 9 o'clock for me. I'm getting ready to go through this hive here to find a queen that I'm sending to my friend in Montana. I just put this box on a couple days ago, so shouldn't be built out that much. I'm sending a queen to Montana as like a little experiment to see if Pennsylvania true survivor bees can make it in Montana, because apparently pretty much there. What the heck, I'm gonna send a good one. I mean, they're all good, but these are my favorite bees ever. These are from, this colony is descended down from my Limerick queen that I acquired in 2017 from a fallen tree in the forest. That queen that I, the original queen that I got in 2017 is still alive in the box about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 colonies down. She's still alive down there. Still cranking out babies and daughters that are very good bees. I never treat any of my bees. Fight me. I don't have fake survivors here on treatments. These suckers take all comers. The bees here in this area over the winter time get zero sunlight ever. There's no sun that hits them. They're in full exposure to wind. I don't insulate except for the lid. And these are great bees. I could yank a queen out of a mating nuke, but I'm not doing that. I'm grabbing one that's doing really well. Try not to get stung to death. It's early. Everybody's home. I'm gonna move real slow, as usual. Can't really do it like this in the summertime or in the fall, for God's sakes. You can't go in a hive with shorts on or a t-shirt like I usually do. You'll get stung to death, even by pretty nice bees. These have always been pretty nice. I'm using a little more smoke than usual. You know, I want to keep them out of my way. This is a weird spot to have bees at. You got this stupid wall right here. Man, they're really glued. The reason I'm going in this early is because I gotta have this queen at the post office by 10 a.m. so that it can be overnighted. Oh man, that's heavy. All right. This time of the year, there's no worry about robbing. We're in kind of an extreme flow right now. I'm just giving them little puffs because they're wanting to shoot at me a little bit. I have to wear gloves because the skin on my hands is very, very reactive to propolis. I'll show you a little picture of it. What happens when I don't wear gloves. Let me see, 3 boxes. I'll get a look in here, see if there's any brood here. See if I can find this queen. I'm going gonna mark her. I don't want to do that with gloves on, so I will have to take it off, to take them off to mark her. I don't want to squish her by, or screw her up by not being able to feel how hard I'm squeezing. I'm a little shaky because I haven't had breakfast yet. I'm so hungry. I got like the stutters and the friggin' twitches. I really should have ate something. I hate when I get like that. I'm rolling a little bit of bees here, trying not to. This hive is really packed. They've actually swarmed twice already this year. So I don't know. Oh yeah. I don't know if you can see that, but apparently when your bees swarm, you lost everything. You lost your honey, you lost all your colony and everything. I'm finding that not to be the case hundreds of times. I got colonies that swarmed 2-3 times with 3 supers on top. You know, still doing great. I'm not stressing. I'm not a commercial beekeeper. I don't make money off bees. This is just all drone comb here, which is good. I want my drones out there. Especially from these bees. Smoke's killing me. Alright, so just moving slowly through here. A little bit more drones and I use mostly foundationless frames. You gotta be careful tilting these bad boys if it's a deep frame with honey in it. It'll snap right out on you. I don't know if I'm getting, I've never done a video like this. I don't know if I'm doing it right. You would love to see my tripod. It's like duct tape. Duct tape my phone to a garden stake. Oh, about 8 feet away. Oh, killing my back. What I should have done was taken all the boxes off and then put them back on as I look through them. I'm taking a chance here of just kind of running her around these 3 boxes that are left. Ugh, let me move this smoker again, it's killing me. I'm usually pretty lucky at finding them. So more about this queen, she's probably produced I don't even know how many hundreds of colonies by now. I've got her daughters in maybe 20 of mine. People have gotten daughters and they've all survived and they've split them so many times. It's just I love this line of bees, they're just the best. I move through a hive like a complete sloth, but that's okay. I don't crush a lot of bees. I mean, a lot of pollen there, brood. Nothing like an inspection video, huh? Oh, look at that. There's some brood, there's some pollen, yeah. We know. And here I am doing it. And in case you don't know, this is not a teaching video. I'm not a bee teacher. I don't do how-to videos. I just do how-I videos. This is how I look through a hive. Nothing really to see. Bees. Is glued. Okay, we got it. Yeah, they're just making some honey here. You're not supposed to make honey. You swarmed like 2 or 3 times. Knock it off. Oh yeah, that's just pure capped honey there. So I'll take this box off. Check the very bottom one. I get this back together here. These bees knew me when I wasn't even the swarm king yet. Which I gotta thank John over at Baddest Bees for giving me that name, swarm king idea. It's just kind of a joke. Am I the swarm king really? We all know the answer to that. I just love catching swarms. Come on. I'm gonna give them a little bit of smoke just to remind them that I'm here trying to do something. So don't be jumping on me. On my legs. Okay. That was my fault. The stupid. I got this stupid hive right up to the freaking wall. They're trying to light me up a little bit. Nope, don't go in there. Give them a minute to calm down. That was my fault. Bring them a little bit of I'm sorry smoke. Sorry about that. Now get the hell back down there. Make me put my suit on, I'm gonna be mad. They're getting a little annoyed. I understand that. Puff them back a little bit. Let me see. Can you even see that? I don't know. Alright. Down here. It way these bees overwintered was in just these two mediums. I like that size. These frames down here haven't been moved much since last year, so they're in there pretty good. I don't like J-hook tools, but I could really use one right now. Man, that sucker's in there. Trying to get some room. I can put a little smoke with them. That'd be a long video. Just little puffs, I'm not killing them. I ain't burning them. Man, that sucker's in there. Finally got this son of a gun out of here. Alright. Bring it up easy. No rush. Alright. That's all pollen. Well, 90% pollen. A little bit of honey on the sides. Okay. Stupid dog going after the chickens. Alright, now we can get in here. Stuck around this long, God bless you. Because I can't stand seeing just regular old looking through high videos. I mean, they're okay. This has a lot of pollen in between all the worker cells. We're getting a little jam there. Thank you. lot of pollen in here. Can't really move your hands fast. Start shooting through your hands. I don't think the queen's even going to be down here. She's probably up in a upper box. Because there's no room down here. I'll just look through the next couple frames and then I'm going to start restacking them. Going through them as I restack them, probably chase her back out of the way again. Or I'll check through first and then restack it. How about that? Frame here is a ton of, looks like, oh, it's not a ton, but there's a good amount of drones on here. Drone comb, which I have no problem with. Make all the mites they want to. Mites kill my bees, I do not want them. So, kill away. I'm thinking this is just going to be honey here. Can't really see it, it's totally covered with bees. I don't know, maybe not. Pollen. Larvae. Next one's all honey. Yeah. Let's see how long this video has been going. How long have you been going? Holy shit, is that 26 minutes? Okay, I'm going to pause this and come back when something good happens. Alright, I'm going to close this video up. This was my tripod. My little thing duct taped to this garden pole here. So nothing really exciting happened, to be perfectly honest. I did not find the queen in this freaking thing. I never went into the bottom box. I just went through each one and restacked them. Did not find that thing. So I was kind of annoyed, but I mean, she's in there. There's eggs and everything. But so what I ended up doing was going to a smaller colony that had a sister of that queen. Same line, same everything. Great bees, but I found a sister of my my limerick queen, which is in that skinny nook there, so I can find her easily and keep track of her and not let her get away. Alright, so the queen was found, taken to the post office, and she's on her way to Montana. So we'll see what happens. See you later.